I've used the bomb in this video twice. Okay. I know, it's such a 90s saying though. Here, and well, my good friend Carmen Q asked me for a video on what's inside my medicine cabinet. So here we are in my bathroom, in front of my medicine cabinet, ready to go inside. Just want to forewarn you guys, no one has been here before. So I feel like females' medicine cabinets are filled with just mystery, beauty, and just good stuff. And well, are you guys ready to go where no one has gone before? Here we go. First, you'll need a wand. I just don't leave this unlocked. Am I right? Welcome to my medicine cabinet. There are one, two, three, four. I don't know if you guys can see the one up here, but don't worry, we'll adjust the camera so you can. But four shelves of goodness. And how I have it separated and organized is my two first shelves are the ones that I use the most, which is my face stuff. And my other two shelves are for my hair stuff. And I'm gonna go ahead and walk you through each of my favorites. So let's go ahead and get started on this first shelf. You guys know I'm a huge fan of Lancer products. So I have all of his stuff right here, and this is like the washing, like exfoliation and the cleansing. So I have the polish, which you guys have seen me talk about this a ton before. Cleanser right here. This is the travel size, and then a big polish right here. And then of course, the travel size Nourish right here. I personally love to buy things in travel size because I think it just, especially living in San Francisco, you just need everything smaller. So even like these big things, like they don't really fit. So I prefer to buy them in the travel size. My Cetaphil cleanser, which I also use just to like break up from like the Lancer stuff instead of using that every day. Sometimes just when things get a little oily around my T-zone, I like to use this. And then of course the Lancer soothing mist. I love this stuff. After I wash, I just and it feels so good. It's so calming, I love it. Dr. Lancer, you guys, this is not an ad. I just freaking love Dr. Lancer stuff. SK2, my friend Eki put me onto this, the facial treatment essence. I also really love this stuff after I wash my face. I put a little bit on my palm of hand and I just kind of pat it through. And I really feel like this gives you a great even skin tone. So I really love it. It's a little on the pricey side, but I really love this. And in terms of like your skin, that's the place to spend, you guys, because this is like, this is, you get one of these, like this is it. So you're gonna wanna like go all out for this. So SK2, huge fan, Eki, thank you for this. And then we're going to back to Lancer for all of my creams. These were the same creams. This is the re-texturizing cream, and this kind of just like a cell turnover, and then this is the Younger Pure Youth Serum. This is just like, I don't know, an equivalent to like eye cream, you know, starting that anti-aging process already. But I love these and I vary between these two every other night. This is the shelf that I use like everything, every day. All right, so now moving to my second shelf, I have the Lancer. I love, love, love this mask, you guys. The Lancer exfoliant, these are the same things. One's in travel, one's the big one. And it is the Caviar Lime Acid Peel. Oh my gosh, you guys, I freaking love this stuff. I love this stuff, I use it like twice a week and it's just, it's the bomb, it's the best. I love it. Lancer, you've done it again. And this right here is my eye cream. I don't actually use this as much as I probably should. I think that's because I have the other serums, but the eye cream when I'm feeling a little tired and need a little pick-me-up. These two are the same. These are both like hydrating masks. And you just put this on overnight and sleep with it, and then it's like your face awakens. It's called the Radiance Awakening Mask Intense. Again, same thing. This is good for like when I'm traveling and my cheeks get really dry, and sometimes like right around here has been getting kind of dry, like around my nose and like right above my lip and stuff. So I'll just put this on overnight and like I'll wake up and it's totally good. All right, Summer Fridays. So a lot of people on my Instagram have asked me about this because I posted that I was trying it. I don't use it as frequently as I probably should to give you guys like a good review on it, but I think it works the same as like the Radiant mask, where it's just like a lot of moisture and hydration. It's a clean product, so, which I think Lancer stuff is too. All of Lancer's products are very, very clean. Anyway, so this stuff, I just decided to try something new. Once in a while, I like to try something new, and this stuff I got in the Sephora in Arizona, to be exact. And it's Potent C by Peter Thomas Roth, and it's supposedly, like, when I saw the before and after pics, I was like, whoa, I need this stuff. Supposedly the strongest vitamin C on the market right now, and it's for like uneven skin tone, wrinkles, and just like texture and brightness. So I knew I wanted to try this. To be honest, I haven't seen like a huge change in my skin, but I don't know if it's like psychological, so I throw it on anyways. I throw it on in the morning after I wash my face, spray it with Lancer Soothing Mist, and then I'll throw this on afterwards, and then I'll put my moisturizer on and my sunblock. But I don't know if it's worth spending the amount of money that's on it. So I think Lancer's is cheaper, so I might just go back to that when this is finished. All right, next is my Lancer Omega Hydrating Oil. It's good. It's not like, oh my gosh, my skin is amazing. Whereas I felt like the Pure Radiance from True Botanicals was like, whoa, my skin is amazing. But this is good. It's good enough, you know? But I think I'm gonna go buy the True Botanicals once this is out, which is gonna take me a little bit. But I like to sometimes mix this in with my SPF, which is Elta MD Skincare. I love this brand. I only buy it in travel size. I should probably buy a big one, but I like travel size, what can I say? But this stuff is my favorite sunblock, and it does the job. And sometimes I throw this on, mix a little of the oil in it to work as like a moisturizer and a sunblock, and you're good to go. So I really like this stuff. And then of course, deodorant, travel size. I have two over here, I really like it. And then I got this in Arizona at Be Current Meditation Spot, and this is just essential oil inspiration. When I'm feeling just like uninspired or just lack of creativity, throw this on a little here, a little here, a little here, a little here, and then hopefully a good idea comes to me. All right, now moving on to hair. I have all sorts of different products. Why? Because A, I don't wash my hair a ton. B, I have curly hair naturally. And C, I also wear it straight. So that's like three different looks, you guys. Okay, so when I wash my hair, I use this Extreme Anti-Snap by Redken. This stuff, I really like it. I think it just helps from breakage. I'm really loving this brand, Briogeo. I don't even know how to say it, Briogeo. So there's no like sulfates and parabens, no silicones, like all that stuff. And I really like it. It's just like a leave-in conditioner that you throw in as you're brushing out your hair, and it helps repair it. But it just makes my hair really soft, and I like the way it smells. I also have the deep conditioner, which I use in the shower. You leave it on for 10 minutes, and it makes my hair so soft, you guys. And then this is like a leave-in mask too. Don't Despair Repair by Briogeo. Strength and Moisture Leave-In Mask, and it's like a spray. So you spray it in, you just leave it in, and you style as normal. But I really feel like my hair has gotten really thick all the way towards the end because of this stuff, or like it stayed stronger for a lot longer and in between haircuts, which is really nice. I've actually noticed a change. I started using this stuff during spring training, and I've actually noticed this, like, a huge change. So I really, really like this stuff, and I give it 2 thumbs up. My next one is Oribe Heat Styling Shield. So I won't use both of these at the same time. I'll just use one or the other. And then this Heat Styling Shield, when I know I'm gonna blow out my hair, I throw a little bit of this on, especially on my ends, just to kind of protect the hair. And then when I'm finished styling, I usually like to throw in a little bit of oil just because my ends get dry from all the heat, like all the tools and stuff. Or when I wear my hair curly, I like to put this on the ends. And this is the Gold Lust Nourishing Hair Oil by Oribe. Big fan of Oribe. Not all of Oribe products, but I'm a big fan of like a lot of their like styling products. Like this one is like my favorite. It is the Oribe Anti-Humidity Spray. So sometimes when I blow out my hair straight, and I go, like, especially in San Francisco around the bay, there's a lot of moisture. Like, the humidity just makes it curly again, especially when I go to the ballpark. Oh, my goodness. I get so mad because I spend so much time on my hair, and then it's just dead. So this stuff right here, my secret weapon, and I use this stuff, like, I just spray it in there. I really get in there, and I just, and this really protects it from all the moisture in the air. Okay, now going up to my top shelf, which you guys can't see, but I'll bring it down. Argan Oil, this is just hairspray. This smells so good. It's by One and Only Argan Oil, derived from Moroccan argan trees, volume hairspray. This stuff smells so good, and it holds a ton. I don't know if you guys remember this. The 2014 World Series, parade here in San Francisco, it rained that day. And I was terrified because my hair is curly and I was like, oh no, my hair is just gonna be a curly mess. Hairstylist Marie Chang, who also does makeup, she came and she put my hair in like a low pony and she made it so cute and she sprayed it with this and my hair stayed and it looked like totally fine. So she saved it for me and I use it sparingly because, well, I just feel like it's so good and I don't know where to buy it. To be fair, I haven't really looked, but I use it sparingly. Okay, this is the Oribe Dry Texturizing Spray. Also really love this stuff. When I curl my hair and I need the curls to kind of break up after like curling it, I throw this in it like around the tips and stuff, and so it just kind of gives it that like texture that you want and not so like perfectly placed curls. So this is the Oribe Dry Texturizing Spray. And then when I wear my hair curly, I use Paul Mitchell's Sculpting Foam. I've been using this since high school. So I've tried all the other fancy curling products and just none of them do the job that Paul Mitchell Sculpting Foam does. So I've switched back to this with experimenting with all the other ones, and I love, this is my jam right here for curls. And then sometimes when my curls are acting finicky or like the next day, I'll throw some of this on and it's the Dave Curl Moisture Lock and it's just to kind of like spruce them up a little bit, or if there's like some frizz in the ends or somewhere like I slept on it weird, I'll throw some of this on and it'll kind of like revamp the curl. And then the gel, I keep this here for Hunter and his curls. He hasn't used it clearly, but if he ever decides, because once in a while he asks for gel or something for his hair. And so I just like to have this here. It's the Dave Curl in gel. And then finally, the Detox Dry Shampoo by Drybar. I love this stuff. I have tried very many dry shampoos and this is by far one of my favorites. Like I said, I don't blow dry my hair a lot, or I don't wash my hair a lot, but this stuff really is the bomb. Anyways, I really like this stuff. The Detox Dry Shampoo, really good. 2 thumbs up. This is what I use until I find something better. Well, there you have it, my medicine cabinet. I hope you guys enjoyed the tour and I'll see you next time. Bye. If you guys like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Also, if you guys want more tours of my bathroom, let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please be sure to do so. Why? Because we post videos here every single week and I don't want you to miss one. See you in the chat. Bye.